are forming the elite, meaning somewhat highly developed 3D negative souls. So, Orion abduction contacts. I'm going to keep reading through here. We have only about 35 minutes left, and I want to at least we'll finish these sections. Orion abduction and contacts. And this is talking about physical examination. Physical examination used as a means of terrifying the individual and causing it to feel the feelings of an advanced 2D being, such as a laboratory animal. Sexual experiences of some are a subtype of this experience. The intent is to demonstrate control of the Orion entities over the Terran, the earthly inhabitant. These are 3D natives, generally. Preponderance of human ET contacts is Orion-oriented. These are important points. The most typical approach of Orion is to choose the weaker-minded entity that it might suggest a greater amount of Orion philosophy to be disseminated. You are a slave, like that. Or, you want power. Power is good. Beat your neighbor. this is Orion philosophy. Domination is good, love is weakness. Some few Orion entities are called by more highly polarized negative entities of your space-time nexus. In this case, they share information just as we do. However, there is a risk for the Orion entities due to the frequency with which harvestable negative planetary entities attempt to bid or order the Orion contact. Just as these entities bid planetary negative contacts. The resulting struggle for mastery, if lost, is damaging to Orion group polarity. Similarly, a mistaken Orion contact with highly polarized positive entities can wreak havoc with Orion troops. Unless the Crusaders are able to depolarize the entity mistakenly contacted, this occurrence is almost unheard of. Therefore, Orion entity or the Orion group prefers to make physical contact only with weaker-minded entities. So, this is pretty hardcore stuff now. So, first of all, this is an explanation about the physical exam type negative contact. Physical exam can be used as a means of terrifying the individual, causing trauma. This is trauma and violation. To feel the feelings of an animal, advanced 2D being like an animal. Some UFO researchers, abduction specialists, have actually said, well, abduction or what appears to be violation, you know, what's experienced as a violation, trauma, contact, is really them trying to help us, just like we try to help Arctic seals. And we tag them, and we inject them, and we take them into zoos, and we do this and that to them. We're just trying to help them, but they can't see it. Or we take a big needle in the emergency room to help the child, but he's terrified and traumatized, but we're only trying to help. Interestingly, making the analogy of the contactee or abductee with an animal or a child is is apologetics or a way of whitewashing negative contact. And Ross says straight up, part of the purpose of a negative contact is to make the person feel like an animal, meaning helpless, to feel violated, fully violated. So, you know, the negatives are tricky, and they weaken people. They like to make people feel that that people have no hope. So Karen says resistance is futile. Actually, that's not true. Resistance is unnecessary, but when the mind is full in power and awareness of unity, negative contact stays away. So such a notion that resistance is futile is actually a negative philosophy. And that's exactly what they would like to suggest to people in the contact of abduction, that resistance is futile. That's bullshit, actually. And it's not even necessary to have a contact with negative force if one is centered in power and oneness. So the preponderance of human ET contacts is Orion oriented. This is a very interesting point. There are not many wanderers here. Wanderers are the only ones getting Confederation contact. So most contacts are Orion. Now we're talking about physical contact. And in many cases, this is choosing the weaker minded entity or the person who isn't centered in their own power or their own clarity of mind, so that Orion can suggest service to self philosophy. Now, as I said, it's also true. Some Orion entities are called by 3D negatives, meaning those who are using mind and will to polarize service to self without love. And very few of those humans are harvestable, but they're trying. And in this case, they share information, meaning the ways of service to self. You know, look at the conspiracy material. Look at the protocols of the Elders of Zion. Whoever wrote that, forged or not, it's clearly very advanced service to self philosophy. Jewish or not Jewish, I don't know. It's not even important. But that's an example of sharing information from 4D negatives so that 3D negatives can put the world into order with themselves at the top. But then there's a risk for the Orion entities due to the frequency with which harvestable negative planetary entities, meaning really advanced 3D negative humans, are bidding, ordering. Bidding equals ordering. Orion, meaning enslaving their demon spirits. And that's done in black magic. Crowley and other magicians know well about certain spells and magical formulae so as to bind the spirits that are being called. And resulting struggle for mastery, struggle for mastery, if lost, is damaging to the Orion group polarity. Similarly, mistaken Orion contact with highly polarized positive entities, meaning wanderers, can wreak havoc with the Orion troops unless the Crusaders can depolarize the entity mistakenly contacted. It is almost unheard of, meaning it doesn't happen. So if Orion contacts a wanderer, it's because they're trying to eliminate him or her. Carla in the channeling was contacted many times by, they actually had a long-term 5D negative Orion visitor who was with them, and lost polarity. That Orion entity lost polarity regularly. So, yeah, this is, you know, the devil's in the details, and it's a really good question. Literally, the devil is in the details. If you see, let's just start from what Ross says. If the contact felt to be violation, terror, and trauma, then it was very likely negative. Now, if the contactor, the contacting extraterrestrial group, is negative, they do not become positive. And even if the person changes their attitude and comes to welcome it, it's still called negative contact. It's still for the purpose of domination and control. It's still not for that person's best interest in terms of love and wholeness. So, it's also possible, as we see here, that a wanderer could be expecting a physical examination or terror or trauma or fear, and the positive Confederation contact would allow them to experience that somewhat, and then when they worked through, it would be seen in a positive light. The thing is, Confederation contacts are generally not ongoing in the same way as Orion contacts are ongoing or appear to be. There are three forms of there are three contactors. Confederation, 4D, 5D, 6D, positive. Orion, generally 4D, 5D, negative, but almost always 4D, negative. Or human covert agencies, military intelligence. Okay, they do abduction, or something like that. Was John Mack helping his clients make positive interpretation of Orion contact? Helping his clients make positive spiritual orientation towards military intelligence contact? These are called MILABS, M-I-L-A-B-S. In fact, you can Google that. M-I-L-A-B-S means military abductions. Lovely, huh? Or was he helping wanderers realize the truth of a positive activation experience with the Confederation? Those are the only three choices, okay? Two out of three are no good. Not very nice. And the question is, are those people wanderers? I don't know. All I would say, I mean, I think it would go case by case, but I would surmise that the majority of people that he's helping move into a positive interpretation or positive mode of reception of the contact, most of those people are getting Orion contact or military contact. That's what I would say. And I would frankly say that the same is of Jacobs and Hopkins. And I've met Bud Hopkins and Jacobs also. And they don't seem to be particularly, God-centered. I mean, I don't think they're bad people. They also both may be military operatives. I don't know, you know. Believe it or not, there are far more of those than you realize. I mean, many, many. You know, this is just my humble opinion. But I would say most of the people... I mean, there are most of the people doing abduction research are probably working with people who are having Orion contact or 3D negative human contact. Okay? Some of them are agents themselves. Nobody is former military. If you're once in, they're always in. I mean, that's how I would assume. That's just how STS works, I think. So, you know, this is voodoo or witchcraft may be related to, so those are early versions of negative magic, mind using energy for service to self. But unfortunately, you know, there are also abduction researchers or therapists, counselors, who are genuinely positive, and they are wanderers, and they're trying to help people. It's just, in general, if the contact evoked fear and terror, then that evocation of fear and terror was part of the purpose. Not that being the human failing, or the failing of the human contactee. But that the trauma, the violation that was sensed and experienced was part of the purpose of the contact. So, yeah. Orion contact is ongoing. You know, so Ross says, the preponderance of human ET contacts is Orion-oriented. So anyway, just, you know, consider all that. When you evaluate other UFO contact researchers, it's a very ugly scene. But in general, what you've got is Orion working with 3D human negatives, working upon 3D human non-polarized souls, meaning people who are not clearly positive also. And, physical examination and implantation and all of that is a portion of that. Some of it's really happening, some of it's not really happening. But some of it is genuine.